As we enter the new decade, Sony surprised us with a concept car that arrived in Tokyo being suspiciously like a real car. What did they have in mind? Hello everybody, welcome to Top Exclusive. Today we bring you Sony's Vision S concept car. The Vision S was introduced as a concept and testbed for Sony's technology. It was never meant for production, although it is a functioning car. However, last month they released a video announcing testing for the Vision S. Testing for what, you may ask? The prototype is currently being developed for public road test. Sony also names a few more technical data about the Vision S. The model receives out-of-the-world updates and it communicates via the new 5G cellular standard. The car weighs 2,350 kilos and it's a four-seater hatchback sedan. All-wheel drive is set thanks to the electric motors at the front and rear. It's not a surprise that electronic companies like Sony actually presented innovations at the Consumer Electrics Show. This year's presentation, along with flying taxis and the Mercedes Vision AVTR, was by far the most impressive one. Just imagine what generation cars are entering. No wonder if any of these companies introduced a literal spaceship in the next few years. Of course, Sony wouldn't make a car without new incredible technology. The concept has all kinds of images and sensors, as well as telecommunications and the cloud technologies from its own group. A total of 33 sensors are installed just on the outside. Where am I? In the movies? No wonder it offers a highly developed driving assistance. There are also cameras instead of exterior mirrors. Its assistance level is currently at level 2+, but it should be expandable to level 4 and more. Overall, the car was built around the infotainment system. The focus was mostly toward the driver and the passengers, and as it's developing, it's aiming the entertainment on the go. But how serious is Sony actually with the Vision S? We will understand only when we take a seat in the car. The entire interior of the car is almost ready for series production. Clear surface, a pleasant feeling of space and a comfortable seating position. Sony's approach to venturing into the project with experienced suppliers has had an impact, because the passenger in the rear also have sufficient leg and headroom without the interior looking random or standard. This is ensured by two rotary push buttons which are located between the seats at the front and at the back, and serve as an additional input for the infotainment landscape. The development of the infotainment system is practically finished, he explains when he strokes the razor sharp LCD touchscreen during our demo and pulls a film from the middle monitor into the passenger's front monitor. This is when the electronic giant clearly shows its strength, and its operating logic is also clear. The left mirror provides all relevant information for the driver, and in level 2 operation, offers information such as speed and route instructions. In the middle monitor, the main menu items are housed in individual columns that can be opened and expanded by tapping and swinging, or can even be pushed onto other monitors. Have you heard of the 360 reality audio? I guess no. It functions when the front passenger wants to watch a film while driving without the driver being distracted. It works with speakers embedded in the seats. This should not only create a particularly good spatial sound, but also the possibility that each passenger can listen to different music or films. For this purpose, the car should always be connected to the internet, plus to enable software updates. The four-door hatchback sedan with a large panoramic sunroof is powered by two electric motors with a total output of 400 kilowatts. It actually isn't as slow as you think. It accelerates from 0 to 60 miles per hour in just 4.8 seconds and can reach a total of 150 miles per hour. However, the Tesla Model S does 0 to 60 in just 2.4 seconds, and the upcoming Roadster is looking at a 220 mile per hour top speed. There are so many speculations that Sony actually has the goal to beat Tesla. Is it true though? Give your opinion down in the comment below. Before we continue, make sure to leave a like and subscribe. And don't forget to turn on notifications, as you can expect big things coming in the future. The performance figures for this Vision S are more on par with Tesla's entry option on the Model 3. Depending on what Model 3 you get, the 0 to 60 is from around 3.5 to 5.1 seconds and its top speed will top out at 162 miles per hour. The Vision S is simply getting put into Tesla's shadow in terms of performance. However, the star of the Vision S is clearly in the electronics inside. In fact, the car part is outsourced to Magnesteer, and most importantly, they didn't reveal the electric battery stats. this could be the main competition point between Sony and Tesla. A $40,000 to $60,000 rolling access to all entertainment Sony has to offer and other luxury features. Remember those rear view screens? Well, rear view screens need rear view cameras, and the Vision S has a total of 10 cameras looking all around the car. An array of cameras aren't the only thing keeping track of the Vision S surrounding, that uses lasers instead of sound. While Sony making a car was an incredible surprise, however, back in 2014, when Sony announced an investment in the company ZMP that developed sensors for robotics, out of nowhere, in 2018, Sony invested an unbelievable $5.3 billion in autonomous car sensor technology research. Now that tremendous $5.8 billion investment is lying in the Vision S. Certainly, the star of the Vision S are the sensors, and the screens were just a way of grabbing some attention to the car. Sony also made a bold statement that their sensor array can see better than the human eye, and in testing in Tokyo, they hope to change the entire game in the autonomous car sensor. Unfortunately, Sony has no plans to make the Vision S available for purchase. The Vision S will live as a testbed for Sony's new technology, which may well possibly be used in their video game sector. However, why did Sony go through the trouble of building a car if it's not going to build cars? Only time will tell. Do you think that Sony will ever manufacture the Vision S? Give us your opinion down in the comments below. That covers up Sony's plans for now with the car industry. If you enjoyed the video, make sure to leave a like, comment and subscribe. All of this helps us a lot. Thanks for joining us, and until next time.